In this session, we will discuss about fertilization. If you take the definition, fertilization is nothing but complex sequence of molecular events starts with fusion of male and female gametes, ends with intermingling of paternal and maternal chromosomes at the metaphase of first mitotic division of zygote. Of course, this definition sounds difficult, but the process is very easy. Actually, fertilization we will discuss under three headings. Mainly, what are those? First one is approximation of gametes. What is it? Approximation of gametes. Second one is fusion or contact of gametes. Third one is effects of fertilization, right? So, approximation of gametes, fusion or contact of gametes, effects of fertilization or results of fertilization. What does it mean? First, both male and female gametes has to come together. That is approximation of gametes. Then, after reaching together, fusion, both male and female gamete will fuse, right? Actually, this is only fertilization proper, right? After that, after fusion, what are the effects, what are the results that we have to discuss in the third step? Clear? First, we will take approximation of gametes, right? Approximation of gametes occur in two steps. That means two processes will be there to complete approximation of gametes. What are those? First one is mechanical. Second one is chemical. Two processes are there. One process is mechanical process and another process is chemical process. This chemical process we can also call as chemotaxis. Clear? First, if you take mechanical process, for that first we should know where male gamete is there, where female gamete is there, both where they should go, right? Actually, male gamete and female gamete, they have to reach one place. That place is site of fertilization. The site of fertilization is ampulla of fallopian tube. Clear? For that, I am taking ovary after ovulation, then semen in the vaginal canal. So, in the vaginal canal, sperms are there. Over the surface of the ovary, ovum is there, ovulated ovum. These two gametes has to reach at the site of fertilization. Clear? That I will try to show in diagram. I am removing this. If you take ovary, this is ovary, this is ovary. Ovary contains different phases of developing follicles, right? Actually, at the 14th day of menstrual cycle, ovum ovulated from the ovary, right? That means ovulation will occur at the 14th day of menstrual cycle. 14th day of 28 days menstrual cycle. 14th day of 28 days cycle. Why I am telling 14th day of 28 days menstrual cycle? If it is more than 28 days, it is not exactly at the 14th day of menstrual cycle. It may vary. That means if it is more than 28 days, at that time what we have to say, 14 days before the next menstrual cycle, ovulation will occur. Right? So, here, ovum will ovulate at the 14th day of menstrual cycle. So, I am drawing graafian follicle here. So, this is primary oocyte with excentrically placed nucleus, and this is surrounded by zona pellucida. This zona pellucida surrounded by cumulus oophorus cells. Cumulus oophorus cells. Right? Then these cells, the totally which are surrounded by, what are these cells? Granulosa cells. And here one cavity is there. What is this cavity called? Antrum. Antrum folliculi. Antrum folliculi filled with fluid. That fluid what we call liquor folliculi. Clear? Now these granulosa cells surrounded by theca interna. Theca interna. These structures you have already studied. Right? Then this theca interna surrounded by connective tissue layer. This connective tissue layer what we call theca externa. Is it? Of course, remaining follicles also there. I am drawing only graafian follicle. At the 14th day of menstrual cycle, this will comes out, exhales out and reaches here. Right? It will reaches over here, and at the same time fallopian tube will become more active. Right? So this secondary oocyte along with cumulus oophorus cells and some amount of liquor folliculi expels out. That I will draw here. So here I am drawing same structure. The same structure I am drawing here. After ovulation, this is secondary oocyte, zona pellucida, cumulus oophorus cells. These are cumulus oophorus cells. These cumulus oophorus cells, now we are no more calling as cumulus oophorus cells. We are calling as corona radiata cells. Why? These cumulus oophorus cells withdraw their microvilli and arrange around the oocyte like a crown. Right? That's what these cells, what we are calling corona radiata cells. Corona radiata cells. Of course, here it is ovulated, and you know the fate of remaining follicle. It will thrown into folds and becomes temporary endocrine organ, what we call corpus luteum. Clear? Now ovum ovulated, it expelled out from the ovary. Now I will draw uterus along with fallopian tube. See here, this is fallopian tube. This is fallopian tube. What is this end? Lateral end of fallopian tube, which contains fimbria. That means finger like projections. What is that? Funnel shaped one. Infundibulum. What is that? Infundibulum. And this is uterus. This is body of uterus. And here is cervix of uterus. Clear? Then at the lateral end there will be opening. Is it? It will be opening into the peritoneal cavity. This opening continues as a tube, canal of fallopian tube. This is canal of fallopian tube. Here, what is this?
cavity of uterus, uterine cavity. Of course, this is another side fallopian tube. And here cavity of cervix. This cavity of cervix having two openings or two ostiums. This is external os and this is internal os. Clear? This cervix opens into where? Opens into vagina. So cervix opened into vagina. Clear? Now, at the time of ovulation, fimbriated end applies closely over the surface of the ovary. Just imagine this is surface of the ovary. Now, ovum ovulated and ovulated ovum is here. This is fimbriated end. This fimbriated end applies closely over the surface and moves forwards and backwards like sweeping movements, right? Along with these sweeping movements, cilia which are present in the lining epithelium of fimbriae, right, these cilia will beats inwards so that fluid current will create. Because of this ciliary beats, fluid current will create, right, so that this secondary oocyte along with corona radiata cells aspirated into the funnel shaped infundibulum. First it reaches to the funnel shaped infundibulum. As soon as enter into funnel shaped infundibulum, musculature, that means muscular coat which is present in the fallopian tube, start contracting and relaxing. That means peristaltic movements. Because of this peristaltic movements, this secondary oocyte along with cumulosuperosis, that means corona radiata cells, reaches to the site of fertilization. Site of fertilization is ampulla, ampulla of fallopian tube. You know the different parts of fallopian tube. This is infundibulum, this is ampulla, this is narrowest part is isthmus, and the part which is present in the uterus is intrauterine part or intramural part, right? So this has been aspirated because of fluid current created by ciliary beads and sweeping movements. It will aspirate and it reached to the site of fertilization. Imagine this is the site of fertilization. So it reached here. You know the structure: secondary oocyte surrounded by zona pellucida, then corona radiata cells. Clear? Now one gamete reached to the site of fertilization and waiting for the another gamete. Another gamete is sperm. Clear? If at the time of ovulation sexual intercourse happened, at the time semen will be deposited. Semen will be deposited in the vaginal canal, where in the fornix and at the cervix of uterus, that means at the external os of cervix of uterus, right? How much semen will deposit here? Per each ejaculation it is around 2 to 6 ml. This is the range. And if you want to say average, it is around 3.5 ml. Clear? This much semen will deposit here. As soon as deposited, there will be activation of one enzyme called vesiculase. What is it? Vesiculase. This vesiculase enzyme coagulates some part of this vesiculase enzyme coagulates some part of semen. Why? Coagulate means it solidifies.
it solidifies the semen to prevent backflow of semen to the exterior, right? To prevent that, this vesicular enzyme will activate and solidifies the semen. Clear? Right. Now, within this much semen, how many sperms will be present? How many sperms? Actually, per each ml, there will be 100 million sperms, 100 million sperms per ml. That means total specimen of semen contains around 200 to 600 million sperms. 200 to 600 million sperms will be deposited at the opening or at the external os of cervix. Actually, within this semen, 10% only, within this semen, 10% of semen contributed by sperms. Remaining 90% contributed by secretions of prostate gland, secretions of seminal vesicles, secretions of bulbourethral glands. These secretions will make 90% of the quantity of semen. Clear? Actually, if the count is this much, this is normal, even though if the count is more than 20 million per ml or 50 million per total specimen, per total specimen, consider as normal, that means consider as fertile. If less than 10 million per ml, this is considered as sterile. That means along with low count, there should be some abnormal sperms will be there, morphologically. Some morphologically abnormal sperms also will be there. That person will remain as sterile. In normal circumstances, he cannot give birth to babies. Clear? Okay. Then, so semen deposited here, at the same time there will be some changes will occur in the uterus also. What are those changes? The glands which are present in the cervix, that means cervical glands, here cervical glands will be there. These cervical glands start secreting, that means they secrete more amount of fluid, and that fluid also less viscid. That means it is not viscous, it is less viscid. It is like water, watery secretions. Why there should be watery secretions? What is the need of it? What is the need of it? Actually, if it is viscid secretions, sperms cannot travel through that viscid substance. They will trap within that and they cannot move forward. Clear? To prevent that, or to facilitate the sperm motility or sperm transport, the secretions of cervical glands are less viscid and more secretions. Clear? Actually, motility of sperms are immotile in the epididymis. In the epididymis, sperms are immotile. But when it ejaculated within the vagina, they are very less motile. Why they are very less motile? In acidic environment, sperms are less motile. Yes, vagina is acidic in nature. Vaginal pH is 3.8 to 4.5 pH. How come it become acidic? Vagina contains lactobacillus. These lactobacillus secretes lactic acid and hydrogen peroxide. Because of these substances, vagina is acidic. What is the need? It helps in the prevention of entry of microorganisms and to kill the microorganisms, right? Because it is opening into the exterior, there is a chance of entry of microorganisms. That's what this arrangement is there, acidic environment in the vagina. Clear? So in acidic environment, sperm cannot move fastly, that means they are very less motile. Clear? Then these sperms will start traveling through the female reproductive tract. Actually, how much speed they can travel? They can travel 2 to 3 mm per minute. If they travel with this speed, can they reach within a time? That means their lifespan is 2 days, right? Within the 2 days, can they reach here when they travel with this speed? It's impossible. That's what we told you, approximation of gametes, mechanical events. Mechanical events. What are the mechanical events will occur in the uterus and fallopian tube? That we will see now. Actually, with this speed they cannot travel. Some support should be there. What is that support? What is that mechanical activity? Here in the semen, there will be some amount of prostaglandins. These prostaglandins will induce muscular contraction of uterus. Where muscles are present? Myometrium. Myometrium muscles will start contracting because of prostaglandins, or with the influence of prostaglandins. Along with that prostaglandins, during sexual intercourse, some coital reflex will be produced. These coital reflexes will influence the release of oxytocin from the posterior pituitary. Release of oxytocin from the posterior pituitary because of coital reflex, right? Because of that oxytocin. That means that oxytocin will stimulate the muscles of myometrium, right? So here two factors are influencing for contraction of myometrium: oxytocin and prostaglandin. With the influence of these substances, myometrium will start contracting. In between the contractions, that means interval between the contractions, there will be creation of negative pressure. That means vacuum will be created within the uterine cavity. When the vacuum created, what will happen? Interval between the contractions, creation of vacuum, so that whatever the material which is present at the mouth, it will be sucked in, like our suction apparatus or vacuum cleaner. Just imagine, if you put vacuum cleaner near to some object, it will aspirate and it will suck in. Why? Within that vacuum cleaner, negative pressure is there. Same thing will happen here also. Because of negative pressure, or because of creation of vacuum, due to contraction of musculature, this semen will be aspirated into the cavity, uterine cavity. Here within the uterine cavity, mixture of semen and secretions of endometrial glands. Clear? Now once they reach uterine cavity, sperms will take nutrition from the uterine secretions. But in the vagina, who will give nutrition? Semen contains fructose. They will take fructose as a nutrition. Clear? Now, along with these mechanical events, there will be chemical events from here. How? Actually, these oocyte and corona radiata cells, they produce some chemical attractions, some chemo attractants. What are those chemo attractants? Actually, corona radiata cells, that means cumulus oophorus cells, produces sterol progestinone. Sterol progesterone. And ovum produce hydrophobic non-peptide molecules. Hydrophobic non-peptide molecules, right? So these substances will attract sperms towards oocyte, right? This mechanism is sperm chemotaxis. What is it? Sperm chemotaxis. Clear? So along with mechanical events, there will be chemical mechanism also. So because of these two events, sperms traveled through the female reproductive tract and reached to the site of fertilization. Clear? Sometimes this ovum migrated within the peritoneal cavity and reaches to the opposite side fallopian tube, right? And it is aspirated by the opposite side fallopian tube, right? So this process, what we call transcelomic migration. Clear? So now both male and female gametes reach to the site of fertilization. Here two more important things we have to discuss here. What are those? Actually, when sperms are traveling through the female reproductive tract, two important events will happen. What are those? Capacitation and acrosomal reaction. These are the final stage of maturation of sperm. Final stage of maturation of sperms. I have to discuss about that. Right? So for that, I need space here. That's what I am removing here. Is it okay? Right? Actually, in the female reproductive tract, two important events, that means last stage of or final stage of maturation, those are capacitation and acrosomal reaction. Capacitation, right? Capacitation means conditioning of sperm. Actually, if you observe sperm, this is nucleus of sperm and it is covered by anterior two-third by what is this? Acrosomal cap, and posterior to this nucleus, anterior centriole, then this is axial filament. At the middle piece, axial filament surrounded by what is this? Mitochondrial sheath. And this total structure covered by what is this? Cell membrane or plasma membrane of sperm. Is it? So this is sperm. Clear? Over the surface of the sperm, there will be deposition of some substances. What are those? Sterol. Example is cholesterol. Sterol. Then epididymal and seminal glycoproteins. These substances will be deposited over the surface of the sperm. These things has to remove, then only sperm will become more active, right? Then only it can move faster. That's what this capacitation will happen. So capacitation will happen in the uterine cavity and fallopian tube. So some substances will be released from the uterus and fallopian tube to assist the capacitation. What are those substances?
If you observe,
there will be sterol binding, albumin, sterol binding albumin, lipoproteins, proteolytic and glycosidic enzymes. These substances produced by the uterine glands and also cells which are present in the fallopian tube. In uterine glands, it's okay. From where these secretions will come in the fallopian tube? If you observe the histology of fallopian tube, you can observe two types of cells: ciliated columnar cells and non-ciliated PEG cells. These non-ciliated PEG cells will secrete these substances. Of course, uterine glands also will secrete these substances. Right? These substances will remove these glycoproteins and cholesterol. Right? It's very simple. Like we will take head bath, no? Same as it is. When you are taking head bath, we will pour water and also shampoo to clean properly. In the same manner, within this uterine secretions, these elements will be there. These elements will clean the surface of the sperm. Right? Once this capacitation happened, what will happen? There will be increased permeability of cell membrane of sperm. For what? For calcium ions, permeability will increase. Right? So, if the increased permeability to the calcium ions, calcium influx will become increased. That means more amount of calcium will enter into sperm. When the more amount of calcium enters into sperm, there will be increased intracellular cyclic AMP. This increased intracellular cyclic AMP will increases the motility of the sperm and it becomes more active. Because of all this process. Right? So, this total process is controlled by FPP, fertilization promoting peptide. This total activity is controlled by fertilization promoting peptide, which will be released from the prostate gland. Clear? I hope you have understood this capacitation. Very simple. Capacitation means head bath. That means total bath of sperm. How? For us, we will take bath with water. For them, no water here. So, uterine secretions. We need shampoo. For them, no shampoo. For that, these substances. Sterol binding albumin, lipoproteins, proteolytic and glycosidic enzymes. To clean what? To clean sterol, epididymal and seminal glycoproteins. So, these substances will be removed by these substances. Clear? So, when they remove these substances from the surface, what will happen? Membrane permeability will alter and it increases the permeability for the calcium ions. Once the calcium ions influx increased into the cell, there will be increased intracellular cyclic AMP. Because of increased cyclic AMP, there will be activation of sperm and also sperms become more motile. Even in our case, when you take the head bath, you will become more active. Is it? Same thing will happen here also. So this total process will takes 7 hours. 7 hours. This is important MCQ, right? So this is about capacitation. Any difficulty up to here? Okay. Now, after capacitation, there will be one more process called acrosomal reaction. What is that? Acrosomal reaction. Acrosomal reaction means what? You know the acrosomal cap. It is formed by the Golgi complex, and it is covering the anterior two-third of nucleus, is it? And there is no any cytoplasm in between the cell membrane of sperm and external layer, that means outer layer of acrosomal cap. Clear? There is no any intervening cytoplasm. Here there will be fusion of outer layer of acrosomal cap and cell membrane at multiple places, at many places, at multiple places there will be fusion of external layer of acrosomal cap and the cell membrane, right? Those fused parts will be broken down so that so many perforations will be present over the surface of the head. So many holes will be formed in the surface of the head. For what? To release enzymes which are present in the acrosomal cap, which are necessary for the destruction of wall which is present around the oocyte. Is it? So let me show that. See, this is plasma membrane of sperm. No, this plasma membrane of sperm fuses with outer layer of acrosomal cap at multiple places, right? This fused part will break down, right? When this fused part break down, there will be formation of multiple pores. This multiple pores will facilitate the releasing of enzymes which are necessary for the breakdown of barriers which are present around the oocyte. Clear? Along with these processes, there will be antigen coating over the surface of the head. Why? Along with capacitation and acrosomal reaction, there will be antigen coating over the surface of the head. Why? Because fertilization is immunological reaction. That immunological reaction will occur in between the fertilin derived from the oocyte, antifertilin derived from the sperm, right? This immunological reaction is species specific. This immunological reaction is species specific. What does it mean? If you try to fertilize human sperm with animal ovum, it will not fertilize. It is rejected immunologically, right? So if you fertilize human sperm with human ovum, then only it will fertilize. If you fertilize animal sperm with same species of animal ovum, then only it will fertilize. Otherwise it is immunologically rejected. Clear? So that antigen coating contains over the surface of head. For what? For egg sperm recognition. For egg sperm recognition. Actually, those substances are carbohydrate binding molecules and gamete specific proteins. They will be present over the surface of the head. These substances are helpful for the egg sperm recognition. Clear? So this process will happen at the final stage of maturation, and when they are traveling through the female reproductive tract. Clear? Now, sperms reach to the site of fertilization. That means they reach to the secondary oocyte. How many sperms will reach? Here, 200 to 600 million sperms are there. Right? Within this much amount of sperms, only 200 sperms will reach us to the site of fertilization. Here, only 200 sperms are there. Right? That means 1 in million reach to the site of fertilization. In how much time? First sperm reached the site of fertilization, it will take 5 minutes. How come we will know this? Scientists observe that they deposited some semen in the vagina and they have observed at the site of fertilization. They found within 5 minutes sperms here. Some sperms they found within 5 minutes. Of course, some sperms they found within after 45 minutes also. Right? So, first sperm to reach to the site of fertilization takes 5 minutes. Clear? Right. So, now all sperms reach to the site of fertilization. All means 200 sperms. Right? Now, I am taking this portion of fallopian tube here to explain fertilization. That means I am enlarging this part of the fallopian tube here as a Dartle diagram. Clear? See here, this is oocyte. Which oocyte is this? Secondary oocyte. Secondary oocyte contains eccentrically placed nucleus, and this oocyte surrounded by zone of pellucida. This is zone of pellucida, and the space between the zone of pellucida and oocyte, that means cell membrane of oocyte, this space is there, no? This space. This space what we call perivitelline space. Perivitelline space. Then this zone of pellucida surrounded by corona radiata cells. Corona radiata cells. Clear? These are corona radiata cells. These corona radiata cells held together, attached together by hyaluronic acid. What is it? Hyaluronic acid. Clear? So, this sperm has to reach cytoplasm of oocyte. That means it has to penetrate. If it want to penetrate here, it has to pass through three obstacles. That means three barriers. What are those? Corona radiata, zona pellucida, vitelline membrane. Vitelline membrane is nothing but cell membrane of oocyte. Is it? Right? So, around 200 sperms, around 200 sperms reach to the site of fertilization. This is fallopian tube, ampoule of fallopian tube. This is ampoule of fallopian tube. I have taken from here and I am drawing here. Right? So, now approximation of gametes, that means both male and female gametes reach to the site of fertilization. Right? Now, actual fertilization, that means actual fusion will start. Right? So, let's take break for some time. Then, we will see the second step, fusion. Clear?